So if a tree falls in the woods and there's no one there to see it, does it make a sound? If there's stuff going on in your body and you can't feel it, is it not going on? Right? You spent a very large proportion of your life trying to ignore stuff going on in your body so you can get on with what you need to do. Do you remember ever having done that? Just maybe once or twice? Digging the garden or, I don't know, writing or... Now you're in a task and there's an ache and you go, let's get on with it. Especially if you're passionate about it, dance. You've got very, very, very practiced at ignoring what the body is telling you. So if you don't feel it, is it going on? That's the trouble. It's not a trouble, it's actually a huge liberation. But only if you fall in love with the body, only if you fall in love with the empowerment that comes from understanding that the stuff you find in there is not happening to you. It's stuff that you are doing, that have been doing. It's not a criticism, it's just a fact, it's a fact of life. We do stuff, and we don't do it the best way we can, so it hurts our bodies. That's just it. We get used to that. I don't want you to get neurotic. I'm not saying you're not allowed to hurt yourself. Because you will. There's nothing you can do without causing some sort of damage. We're getting older, you know? We're on this earth. You're breathing, you're moving. Stuff will happen. What the yoga does is it gives you a chance to look at how you're doing stuff. And in the intention to remove violence, you remember you have to work hard, don't you? You find yourself working hard. The first thing I got you to do, and you're like the Mahapranayama thing. Everyone's calling it by its name now, so that's coined. But that thing, it was hard work, wasn't it? The first time I got you working hard, yeah. But you were just lying down. It's not something you would think to do. What came out of that? What came out of that? From everything you're saying, it sounds like you're getting a bit more present, a bit more aware of what's going on, a bit more of a connection between I do something and something happens. A bit more involved in your body, essentially. Is that a fair assessment? So you're noticing stuff, and it's quite natural to, when you notice some stuff happening, to think something's gone wrong. Because normally, the only time you notice something in your body is when something has gone wrong. Where there's a pull on a muscle, where there's an ache, where there's something that you have practiced ignoring to get on with what you want to do. Yeah? So the biggest job, I think, first of all, is what, that's why I was impressed with what Brenton was saying. The first job is this practice of turning up for the journey. Now, you got on the train, and you're going to be spending time doing this now. Now you've become aware of your body and your environment and your relationships between those things. It's going to be quite a hardcore effort for you to go back to not noticing. You'll have to actually deliberately try to ignore everything in order to go back to how things were. So you're now on this journey. We've got you on this journey, so sorry about that. But if you're aware that the journey involves just sort of taking out, you're going through your luggage while you're on the train, you see. And you say, oh, what am I carrying this crap around for? And Jesus Christ. And you know, every now and again, you just stop and enjoy the view. Because there's a lifetime of this journey ahead, where you are involved with your environment, with your touch, your breath. Okay, you've got to make it enjoyable, otherwise you're going to be waiting till you get there. What happens when you get there? I don't know. So it sounds like death to me. So do settle in to the journey. All that's happened is a switch has been flipped from it is happening to me to to I'm involved in this. And you're just sort of starting to notice things. So you're bound to get worried about your own involvement. You're bound to get worried about aches and pains and things changing. In that moment of it worrying you, just stop for a moment and just think, what have I been doing? I've been lying down. I've been feeling what it's like to stand on my feet. I've been seeing what it feels like to breathe and meet space. So this pain in my rib, this change in my spine, this ache in my back, have I really done something bad to myself? You can work it out. Just stop and tune into what you've been doing and notice. Because the other way around, you know about it. You know, when you've hurt yourself, you go, oh, I shouldn't have done that. I know I shouldn't. I knew I was doing that when I did it. Didn't you? You know, when you notice something that's gone, that actually has happened in your body that's not that useful, when you've actually hurt yourself. Am I right or not? Even you know, when you have food poisoning, I knew I shouldn't have had those prawns. You kind of know. Right? And all this is doing is we're going to be giving you some form, a shape, a sequential sort of way of looking at things that empowers you to deal with stuff as and when it comes up, as opposed to it just happening to you and you running to the yoga teacher just to fix it for you. Do you see what I mean? And this is the empowering thing. This is the thing that I want to share with people is, do I know anything more than you? I don't know. I thought about it more than you, probably. But I haven't got, my nervous system is no more advanced than yours. I spent more time with it, perhaps, listening to what it does and what it tells me. I've spent more time playing with how things can go. But your nervous system is sweet. It's this amazing thing that can tell you everything you need to know if you're not in a fearful relationship with it. And the basic practice of lying on your back and embracing will help you learn how that goes. So do you want to take me through something like that? Just to sort of revisit, and I'll carry on setting up this stuff. What's going on here?